Good evening, Monrovia!
Hi, my name is Debbie Collins. I'm the principal from Plymouth School in Monrovia. And I watch KGEM Monrovia. It's a very important way to keep connected to what's happening in this town. I hope that you all tune in on a daily basis to keep informed of what's happening in the school system, in the city, and all the things you ever want to know about Monrovia.
All right, are we someplace in Hollywood? Hey, an opening of a premiere theater. Oh, you know where we're at? We're in downtown Monrovia, and after great anticipation, you know what? The Krikorian Theater is open in the city of Monrovia. They're doing everything they can to get it all spiffy and nice for the final finishing touches. All right, to the viewers out there that's just tuning in, I'm here with George Krikorian, and it's opening day in a sense. We're here at the New Lady on Myrtle, and you're saying, who's the New Lady on Myrtle? The Krikorian Theater, getting all prepared and decked out. How's everything, George?
Everything's just wonderful, Ralph. Thank you very much.
All right, why don't you tell the viewers, we're standing right here in the lobby.
Right. Well, this is our lobby, and it's not quite finished yet, but it will be tomorrow when we open for business to the public at 5 o'clock tomorrow, Friday.
Okay, which now that's probably what date is that?
That's the 17th.
The 17th of November. Let's talk about some of the artwork that we have.
Well, what we did was we commissioned an artist, Greg Balerian. He's done an incredible job. This is a digital impression of different moods that movies create for people, such as...
We're still working, yeah. But go ahead.
Such as horror movies and how they scare people. And the love scenes in the movies, like this is a takeoff from Gone with the Wind here, with poetry and vision, surrounding it. And up to the left here, these are from the Wizard of Oz, and it's an interpretation of the Wizard of Oz. I think he's done a beautiful job.
Right.
And
right.
We also have some additional artwork in our lobby, further down the other end to the left.
Okay.
And there you have. Portraits of many famous artists, and their images have been digitally enhanced, so it's kind of a challenge to figure out who's who. So it'll be a lot of fun to come in and see that.
All right, now, what do you do on a day like this? I know everything's running around, you're trying to get totally prepared for the opening for the patrons and all of that, but today, what takes place today?
Well, mostly I worry about everything and everybody getting done. As you can see, it's always the last-minute stuff that causes a lot of consternation. But the main thing is that we get everything done for the public, for the safety of the theater patrons, that all of the movies are on the screens, that all the sound systems are working properly, that the ticketing system's working properly, and we get our concessions set up. Those are all the things that we really concern ourselves with right now.
All right, can we go out front, and maybe you could talk about the front of it. It's a sight to see at night with all the bright lights.
If we go out front, we have to walk out to the right here. They're doing some work.
All right. All right, let's talk a little bit more about the Krikorian Theater.
Okay. But we're standing out in front of the lobby on Myrtle Avenue here, and you can see they're still doing a lot of cleaning here. All the new hardscapes have been put in by the city in the front. And over to your left, at the entryways here, we have all these custom mosaics that were just installed. They're still wet and drying, and they'll be dry and ready to walk on tomorrow afternoon. The columns are covered with beautiful marble stonework, and then we have a real custom canopy designed sign out here with a blade sign on top of that that's all very well lighted with some very fancy neon lighting on it. The canopy is not yet completed because underneath the canopy here, this will be completed in different shapes and colors of metal, as well as a neon lighting. And that'll all be done hopefully tomorrow as well. And there are also some poster cases that will be mounted on the walls out here in the next few hours.
Well, something about the mural is behind us, so better yet, you explain.
Well, these are the artist's impression of various artists. And the trick is they're all digitally enhanced, so the trick is to look at them and to see if you can figure out who's who.
Now, does any other theater have this?
No. This is the first time that something like this has ever been done. We commissioned an artist to do this work special for this theater. It's, you know, very unique.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We'll try to figure out the stars.
Okay, Ralph.
Good luck. All right. I'm with someone that probably needs no introduction to the city of Monrovia, Don Hopper. How are you doing today?
Good, Ralph. How are you? Nice to have KGEM here.
All right. Always good to be recognized. Let me ask you a question. What's your take now that it is here and is open?
You know, it's such a long time coming from the time that Mary Wilcox and the Vision 2000 group was trying to vision, you know, what Monrovia could have in the future, and the theater was the centerpiece of that. In 1994, 95, and here we are 5 or 6 years later, and we're ready to cut the ribbon this evening. I think it shows the dedication of this community to have a first-class facility, and that's what this will be. This will be a real attraction for the San Gabriel Valley, and I think will be the centerpiece of the community for a long time to come.
All right, now, Monrovia has a unique reputation as being the talk of the town, and as one president said, a model for the nation. Now, what's going to be your first movie that you check out?
You know, I'm a big sports fan, and I think the one that I would check out first here is the Titans. Remember the Titans.
All right, that's a classic. That's a good movie.
I think that's what Monrovia is about. You know, remember Monrovia, remember the Titans.
All right, sounds good to me. Now, what do you do here today?
Oh, I'm just going to enjoy this and try and help people take a look around at the theater and enjoy this evening.
All right, sounds good to me. Let you get back to work or pleasure.
Nice to have KGEM here.
All right, good. Hey, I'm here with the assistant city manager of the city of Monrovia, Scott Ochoa. How you doing today?
Really good, Ralph. It's really exciting tonight.
Really exciting.
What? Very exciting.
For some of those viewers that may have just tuned in, what's taking place?
This is the ribbon-cutting ceremony for the Krikorian Premiere Theatres here in Old Town Monrovia. So what we have here are dignitaries, city officials, Chamber of Commerce, downtown merchants who are welcoming Krikorian into the family of downtown merchants.
So a little PR is taking place.
Quite a bit of PR is taking place. This is a homecoming for the theater.
So I dubbed it as a new lady on the street of Monrovia, and she's decked out pretty fine. Wouldn't you agree?
I would agree. You take a look through it. It's a first-class place, top drawer all the way.
All right, now, who's the person that can show me the projection room? I always wonder what that looked like in there.
You know, it's interesting. I finally saw a projection room myself, and I always used to think it was a projection booth. But actually, the concourse that you'll see right over here, it's very similar to that, where it's completely open. The only booth, so to speak, is the large format screen booth. Everything else, it's pretty much wide open. You can walk through and see 12 or 11 projectors stretched along this long hallway. It's really interesting.
All right, what's the first movie you're going to check out?
Well, I know my son's going to make me see Rugrats in Paris. So I haven't seen anything other than a kid's movie for about 3 years now. So
right, now you can catch up on your movie. Buddy.
Exactly.
All right, sounds good.
Hey, thanks a lot.
All right.
Have a good time.
Bye. When you talk about a grand opening, you're always talking about food and preparation, and everybody that watches KGEM knows Ralph Walker loves food. Now, who's providing a catering service?
It's Herb Time Catering Monrovia.
And what is your name?
I'm Sandra Hannah Frazier, chef and owner.
Oh, chef and owner.
That's correct.
What do you have right there?
We have some homemade pork tamales with a chili verde and an ancho chili sauce.
What's some of the other things that you're going to have?
We have, if you hold on 1 second, I'll get you a menu and tell you everything I got.
All right, come on back. All right, tell us what's on the menu.
We have, on our Caribbean side, calypso pork loin with island salsa. We have jerk, grilled breast of chicken. We've got a tropical fruit salad that's really good. On the Southwestern, we got the tamales you see here. We've got Chilorano squares. We got spicy black beans with a tri-tip fajita, roasted corn raw, and twin salsas of blue corn chips. On our Asian side, we've got Oriental chicken salad with soy sesame dressing, sesame noodles with Thai dressing and bay shrimp. On our fancy side, we got a mescaline green with Asian pear, Maytag blue cheese, and champagne vinaigrette. We got gourmet cheese, crackers. We've got an antipasto grocery.
In other words, you have something for everybody.
I got something for everybody here.
Sort of international dish, huh?
Yep, absolutely.
All right, you'll see us later.
All right, I'll be here.
All right, thank you.
I'm still breathing.
All right, I'm sitting in movie theater number what? What number is that? Number
10.
Number 10. Movie theater number 10, as you can see, it's quite spacious. Hey, it's looking good. And you know what? The seats are real comfortable. Got something to hold your drinks. And you know what? I think they're going to fill up all how many screens is it?
12?
12 screens. Can you believe it? You got enough room for everybody. Why haven't let the picture start? Hello there. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine today.
All right. What's your take on the new movie palace in Monrovia?
Well, I just think it's great, and I just hope I be here for it.
Oh, well, you seem like you're, well, that's tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow, yeah. I'm telling you. So it's just great. People, you got people here from everywhere.
Now, some of the viewers out there that don't know you, you're Miss Polk, right?
Yes, I am.
All right, see, you didn't think I knew you, did you?
Yeah, I know you remembered me.
All right, now, what's your first impression? They say first impression says a lot about anything.
Anything. Well, first, you had a bad first impression because they made us go around to try to get into here. Didn't have nobody out there to guide us in and everything.
Okay.
So that was the bad impression.
All right, but now that you're in.
Yeah, and everything looks great.
It looks good.
Yes, it does.
Do you have a movie lineup that you want to see?
No, I don't, but as quick as I get the paper, I'm going to find one.
All right, sound. What about your grandkids and all that? You ready to bring them?
Not yet.
All right, who are your friends that's with you right
this
here?
This is my friend Rebecca Hooks, and Hello. She's an old-time Monrovian.
All right, Ms. Hooks, how you doing?
Hi, today? I'm fine, thank you.
And your first impression?
Very nice, very nice. It's going to be a big, big theater, isn't it? I hope we can fill it up. I'm going to try. I'll be one of them.
All right. Any particular movie that you're going to check out?
No, not really. I don't have anything in mind. Whatever comes up and I think I'll like it, I'll try to attend.
All right. Sounds good to me. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you very much.
All right. Oh, introduction right here. We can get them. They're so busy. That star quality right here. Come on over here now. How are you doing?
Just fine.
All right, to the viewers out there, as a business owner in downtown Monrovia, what does the theater mean to you?
Well, being the owner of Mystic Sisters, my sister Carol and I are quite thrilled to have the theater opening tonight.
All right, Carolyn, your first impression as you walk through the door?
Very exciting. Very nice theater. It's going to bring a lot of new business.
Sounds good to you, huh?
Very good.
You can hear that jingle, jingle.
Now,
any movie comes to mind to you that you would like to see?
The Grinch would be great. The Grinch would be a lot of fun. Bring my daughter.
Oh, okay. And how about you?
How about Bounce?
Who?
The new movie with Gwyneth Paltrow and Ben Affleck, Bounce.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Sounds good to me. Maybe I'll get to check it out.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
All right. Hey, you know when Monrovia opens up something special that you're going to get people from all over the world, and we're honored to have right here in the lobby. Dennis Mike, how you doing today?
I'm not from all over the world. I live in Monrovia.
You live in Monrovia?
I live in Monrovia. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have for 12 years.
Now, some of the viewers out there might say, well, what does he do?
What do I do? I'm the fellow who does the Hollywood Minute on CNN, the headline news all over the world, places where they don't even speak English. I wonder why they even bother to watch. That's what I do. Everybody has to do something. That's what I do.
All right. Now, who's the young
this
person that you have
Allison.
Right here?
This is Allison, and she's not talking. She's
How are you
eating.
Doing today?
Fine.
How do you like the movie theater so far?
I like it.
It looks nice, huh? Some beautiful brown eyes.
Thank you.
What movie do you have in mind?
The Grinch.
The Grinch. That's going to be a big seller, huh? All right. Any particular reason why you like The Grinch?
I've never seen it before. I want to see it. And I'm getting bored of the commercials.
You're getting bored of it. Did Dad ever read you the book?
No, but I've got the cartoon movie.
Oh, shame on you, Dad. You never read it. Oh,
I've read plenty of other books.
All right.
Ask her about One Fish, Two Fish. Never mind.
All right.
Anyway,
enjoy yourself.
Pleasure talking to you.
All right. All right. How are you doing today?
Fine, thank you.
All right. Jamma Rock.
Yes. Good
and
to see you.
What's your take on a new lady that's on Myrtle?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Oh,
great.
Just
beautiful.
Terrific. Really oh, is. We're so excited.
We've lived here since 1921. Monrovia.
Oh, okay. So you can recall when there was two theaters in town.
That's right, yes.
Oh, we're going back into the archive. All right, take care and enjoy
okay.
yourself.
Thank you.
All right, then. Doing y'all dressed up like it's the wintertime?
Oh, it is winter.
And what is your name?
Mrs. Kilgore.
Okay, and you live in Monrovia?
Yes, uh-huh. I live on South California.
All right, and what's your first impressions of the
I think
theater?
It's just wonderful, and it's giving the young people a chance to get jobs, and I think it's so great to have some entertainment here in Monrovia. I think it's wonderful.
Hey, you should be in the PR department. That sounds good. And who's your friends right here?
Mildred Watson.
Okay.
And what is your name?
Oh, I'm Ralph Walker, Channel 3 KGEM, but that's not important.
Oh, it is.
Tell me, what's your take on the new theater?
Oh, this is great. It's great for Monrovia.
And any particular movie that you have mind to check out here?
Not at the present time, but I'm coming because I enjoy the movies and that big screen.
All right. You know they have the seniors.
It's stole Christmas. I want to see the Grinch.
And he brought Christmas to Monrovia.
He brought Christmas to Monrovia.
All right, thank you so much. All right, this is a moment everyone's been waiting for.
Absolutely terrific. I think everybody's excited about this. What a wonderful event and business for Monrovia. Just terrific.
Now, a lot of people are probably wondering what impact does this have on the police department when you open up something this grand?
Well, it's kind of interesting because when the city approved this theater here a couple of years ago, they authorized four additional police officers to be able to make the Old Town area a specific beat of its own, so that we'll have an officer in the area all the time. And we've expanded our beat configuration to accommodate that.
All right. Now, another question that some of the viewers at home may be wondering about is we got all the kinks out for parking.
Yeah, well, we're working on all the parking. It's coming along really well. They've got a lot of parking in the area here, and the signage and the directions are going to be going up any day now. We think it should be done by the end of this week. And we have, for tonight and for tomorrow night, we have Explorer Scouts out there handing out directions to the different parking areas in the downtown area so that people will become familiar with that.
All right, thank you so much, Rob. And enjoy the evening.
That's
all right,
great.
What particular movie are you going to watch or check out?
Well, I promised my granddaughters that tomorrow I'm going to bring them and see The Grinch.
Oh, all right. So, number one, huh?
Yeah, that's what they want to see.
All right, thank you so much.
That's right.
All right. All right, how are you doing today?
I'm okay. By the way, I enjoy this. It's beautiful.
All right, now as
in our town, in Monrovia, beautiful, nice restaurant.
All right, now as a business person in Monrovia, what does this mean to you?
This is the good things for our location, for the business people, and for the all residents. We are happy, by the way, and we like to enjoy this movie theater all over.
All right, any particular movie you're going to see?
Pretty soon, I hope. Nice, good movie, something. Let's see. What kind of movie? Thank you, by the way.
All right, take care now.
Thank you.
All right, good man. How are you doing today?
Excellent, excellent. Glad to be here. Glad to have this movie theater in town. We're excited about it.
Now, who's this attractive woman next to you that you're taking to the movie theater?
That's my good-looking wife. I'll tell you what, we don't go to movies too much, but we'll come on over here.
Right.
Right in our backyard. We love it.
All right, any movie in particular that you're going to see?
No, I'm interested in I'm not sure. Not IMAX. What's the other one? EX something. Anyway, that's the one we're interested in.
All right, you're
the
going
big
look.
Screen.
Yeah. Oh, the big screen.
Yeah, the big screen. I've never seen one of those.
Take care and enjoy.
Okay,
thank you.
Your name?
My name is Janet Winchell.
Okay, you have a business here in town?
I'm opening a business, Bella Soleil, right across the street.
And what will be the specialty?
It's going to be jewelry and clothing.
Oh, all right. Now, what's your take on the theater?
I love it. It's very deco. I've been anxiously waiting.
All right, and who's your friend right here?
Tina Luzzi. Only Events by Design.
Okay. Now, I associate you with scouts all the time. Why is that?
Because I'm very involved in the City of Monrovia's scouting program, what, Foothill Unity Center, a few other things.
So the scouts should really enjoy this, right?
Yes, absolutely.
You want to bring the troopers here?
Sure, all absolutely.
Right. Any movie you think you're going to hit them with?
Everybody wants to see Rugrats in Paris.
All right, Rugrats in Paris. All right, a hot movie. All right, enjoy the food. It seems like they laid out everything. Rare commodity with all these adults right here. How are you doing today?
Good.
Do you like the theater so far?
Yeah.
Oh, nice and new, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Any particular movie you like to see?
The Grinch.
Oh, every kid wants to see The Grinch. Any particular reason why? Why The Grinch?
I don't know. Because I want to.
Because you want to, and that's good enough. What about Dad? How are you doing, sir?
I'm doing fine.
And what's your favorite movie that you want to check out?
Well, any of the IMAX stuff.
Oh, the big screen.
The big screen ones.
All right. No IMAX here, though.
Well, one of those large screen formats.
Yes. And your wife over here, what's your take on all this?
Well, I think it's wonderful. I'm very happy that this is happening, and hopefully it's going to be very nice for Monrovia. Yeah.
Thank you.
Looking forward to see the movies.
Happened.
Yeah, I told you. I told you.
Some folks said no, it wasn't going to happen.
No, we knew it would happen. It was just a matter of when, and tonight's the night.
Yeah. I dubbed it as a new lady on Myrtle, and she looks pretty good to me.
Yeah, she looks beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is an incredible job. This is better than we had hoped for, and we hope real big. So, no, this is a good one.
And it only can get better for downtown Monrovia?
Yeah, that's what we think.
What's next? What's going to go in next door?
Oh, I don't know. There's actually a line of businesses waiting to go in there. And the owner of the building is going to have his choice, basically. Okay. It could be a restaurant, could be a bookstore, could be a number of things.
And after tonight, they're really going to be jockeying for a spot.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
All right, I know you're a busy camper. Who's the band that's going to be performing, do you know?
I don't know.
All right, maybe that's my job to go find out.
Yeah, you go find out. All right. Okay.
Thank you much.
Spotlight on the food.
Sorry.
You following me? Come on, good girl.
Yeah.
Impressing.
I want to see what you're eating.
Now, wouldn't it be interesting if I could meet the artist to put together this particular artwork? What is your name?
Gregory Bellerian.
Now, that sounds pretty interesting. I think, did you have something to do with this artwork?
I made them.
You put it together?
Sure.
Now, what was your inspiration behind?
The movies, you know, enjoying the visuals, imagination of people trying to create something interesting for people to look at and have, you know, something that when people are here online waiting to go in, they could have a good time looking at artwork, enjoying art.
Now, is there any particular actor or actress that stands out in your mind?
Not particularly. I mean, I probably had some inspiration in choosing the people that I did choose. There's 50 famous movie stars, and then there's a couple of surprises in the wall.
Okay, and if you're good, you can find them.
Exactly. Some are a little more challenging to recognize than others, but I wanted to, you know, give something exciting for people to, you know, not make it so easy.
All right, now when you walk into the lobby area, there's also an interesting poem that's centered around Gone with the Wind.
Right. That piece is called The Kiss, and the poetry around it, I was inspired by that by imagining my relation with my wife, and the love that I drew from that is what gave me the words for the poetry for that.
All right, now is your wife here tonight?
She is.
All right, let's bring her over here.
This is my wife, Judith.
All right, a pleasure to meet you. We have something in common. I have a wife named Judith also.
Oh. Is she French as well?
No, she's from Jamaica.
Cool.
So that's pretty romantic also. All right, now let's talk about the poetry and your wife.
Sure. Well, you know, first we watched the movie again, Gone with the Wind, and essentially what I wanted to do is I knew I wanted to put words in there, inspiring words about love, and to draw from that experience, I went to, you know, the deepest and closest relationship I could find that would give me those experiences from, and that's her, of course. My love, my true love. So.
All right, now what's your take on that, Judith? You walk into a grand opening of a place.
I'm so proud of him. It's amazing. It's great. It's beautiful, and the theater, amazing. So no, I can say just I'm very happy. It's great.
Now you know many people are gonna walk in there and they're gonna say this poem is for me.
Well, I know it's for me, but you know, it's for everybody. It's for every woman, you know. Like, I think I can share with everybody. It's for all the people of the world if they want to read it.
Sure. You know, we wanted to give something to the people. We knew this is a community environment, and we wanted to create something that would be enjoyable, not just the first time, but you know, each time you come. There, you could look for things that you didn't see the first time. So we've included, you know, some depth in there and some surprises in the images, you know, little things that the young kids can look for. And I won't say what they are, but they're there.
All right, thank you so much and enjoy yourself.
Thank you.
Have fun.
A culmination of about 5 years of a lot of dreaming and planning, figuring, refiguring, planning, replanning, and a lot of very hard work from many folks in our community and obviously from the theater folks. And I think from what you're seeing tonight, I would say that all that work and all that planning and replanning has been worthwhile. This beautiful theater is a result of the kind of partnerships that have made Monrovia what it is today. It was born out of the imaginations of the Vision 2000 Committee, which is a committee of our merchants from our downtown, property owners working with the chamber and the city, And again, they came together to develop a strategic plan to take our downtown into the new millennium, the new century. We were very fortunate to find an extraordinary partner in George Krikorian and the good people of the Krikorian Premiere Theatres. Yes. George Krikorian and his group took that dream that we all had, that vision, and took it further than we had ever hoped, and what we're seeing here is the reality of that vision. We have many people who have worked very hard on this project for the last 5 years, and I think that we need to acknowledge some of those individuals. I'd like to thank the planning commissioners that were responsible for working through all of this. Our commissioners, Eric Faith, Maria Guerra, Dana Hendricks, Dr. David Ho, Mimi Mensi, Glenn Owens, Don Field, and our commissioners from the Historic Preservation, Donna Baker, who's here, and McIntosh has been here, Scott Thomas, Steve Baker, John Petrovich I saw, Kent Cornwall I saw, Tim Shea I saw. A lot of these folks did a lot of work and guided this project from the very beginning. I also like to give a special thank and acknowledgement to the business people and the property owners of our old downtown, not only for their vision, their guidance, but especially for their patience the last 3 weeks, the entire process, and I guess for their patience for the next few weeks while we still finish all the streetscape and the landscape and all that has to be done. Thank you for your patience. And also, I think that we need to give a lot of thanks and acknowledge the leadership of our Merchants Association, the Mayor's Advisory Committee, for their trust and the support of the hard work, and again, for believing in this project and making sure that it came to fruition. We need to acknowledge also the Vision 2000 Committee for the vision, for going out on a limb and making this project come true. The Chamber, very important, the Executive Director, John Veenstra, over here. Chamber Executive Director did a very good job in facilitating a lot of the work and a lot of the sessions in making this project a reality. And again, also a thank you to the voters of Monrovia that approved this project way back in March of 1997. I think we also need to thank our city manager one more time, Don Hopper, for the tenacity to make this happen. Development staff, public works staff, community services staff, police staff, fire staff, for the work that they've done in putting all this together. Special thanks to Robert Kastenbaum, David Pike, Bob Castellano, Glenn Cox, Doug Benash, April Soash, and all their crews. And a special thanks to Mark Alvarado from the finance department who brought redevelopment financing to this project. And I also want to give special thanks and a big acknowledgement to somebody that, a couple of folks that are not here tonight but are very important in making this project come true. And that is to Mayor Bob Bartlett, that while he's not here, he's still doing the city's business and trying to bring more economic development and increase economic development of our community. I'd like to also thank again our Mayor Pro Tem Tom Adams, and council members Joe Garcia and Rob Hammond for helping to make this night possible. And lastly, somebody very important that worked very hard for this, and that is our former councilwoman, Mary Wilcox, whose vision for this downtown became our vision, and without her, we could not make this possible. Special thanks for the committee that put this event together tonight, the Theater Grand Opening Committee, is the City of Monrovia staff, and Pinadas Gourmet, responsible for the hors d'oeuvres, Earth Time Catering for the International Buffet, I got that, the Wine of the Month though, Paul Camillerian, the Bill Brencher Combo, and someone whose name does not appear on this program, but very important, Gloria Hustle and Gloria Floral, made all of the floral and all the flower arrangements, and I think this whole room needs a special thanks and a special acknowledgement.
Okay. Whoever hasn't been introduced and who has been very supportive and very patient, let's hear it for you. Yay! I would like Mr. Krikorian, George Krikorian, to come up, please.
Mr. Krikorian, I know you want me to call you George, but Mr. Krikorian, I want to welcome you to Monrovia and to show our a little bit of our appreciation for this collaboration. We'd like to present you a plaque that says the City of Monrovia welcomes Krikorian Premiere Theatres in the community and celebrates the opening of the new Monrovia Cinema, November 2000. Thank you.
Although you're not a new chamber member, you've been a member now for 3 years, but the Chamber of Commerce would like to present you with a plaque now that you have a place to hang it up. Another presentation is from Pat Myers and
Jay Gomez from
I'm sorry. I did it out of order.
That's okay. No, state senator takes precedence over the supervisor.
I like your order very much. Mr. Krikorian, I remember 5 years ago, we stood out in this parking lot and said it seemed like 10, but that's how I remember. Anyway, Senator Mountjoy and Assemblyman elect Dennis Mountjoy, I'd like to present this and wish you a full house 12 times over every day. Thank you.
There was a question right now from our councilwoman. Did I introduce you? No, if you didn't introduce me, that's okay.
This is Jay Gomez from County Supervisor Mike Antonovich's office.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sir, let me congratulate you on behalf of the supervisor, the Board of Supervisors. I was here at the groundbreaking. It was a cold night. The wind was blowing. And this is beautiful inside. And thank you for bringing this to Monrovia. And if I could read the commendation, it states, with sincere congratulations and best wishes, the Board of Supervisors of the County of Los Angeles does hereby join in your celebration, Michael D. Antonovich, Supervisor 5th District. Mr. Krikorian, God bless you and thank you.
Thank you very much.
Everyone, it's an honor for me to be here on behalf of Senator-elect Bob Marguette, and certainly this is an exciting day for Mr. Krikorian and the community. Today, the Monrovian citizens can finally stay within their own community to fulfill their movie-watching needs and keep their sales tax dollars here in the community. And so it is my honor to be able to recognize Mr. Krikorian and welcome him on behalf of Senator-elect Bob Marguette and present him the certificate of recognition from the Senator-elect and the California State Assembly. Congratulations and thank you. Thank you.
Anybody else with a presentation or a plaque or money?
That's money.
Okay, Mr. Krikorian would like to have a few remarks.
Okay, members of the city council, Chamber President Olson, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. And it's just a pleasure to have you all here tonight. It looks great to look out to the corners here, and to all so many people. We're glad to be nearing the completion of this project. As you know, a project like this is a collaborative effort that involves many, many people. And I would just like to take a moment, if I may, and give thanks to some of those people now. First, of course, we want to thank the City of Monrovia, the City Council, Planning Commission, and all the other committees in the city for giving us this opportunity to build a theater, and we hope you're pleased with what you see tonight. I want to thank all the people in the city that we had the pleasure and opportunity to work with for the last couple of years in getting the project designed, developed, and constructed. Most particularly, the city manager, Don Hopper. Thank you, Don. City development manager, Glenn Cox. He's just been a great support and a good form of communication with the city throughout the entire process. CDC director, Robert Kasterbaum. And all of the people that have worked with these folks in their departments. I want to thank our architects who did a splendid job in designing the building shell, the exterior elevation, the interior improvements. Starting with P&R architects, it's Mario Savopoulos is here. Mario, raise your hand. Hopefully you're here. Thank you, Mario. And special person, Rustan Zaylian and his team at Gensler. Rustan, I hope you're here. Fantastic job. And to all the construction crew who worked so diligently, particularly these last few days, to get this project completed. Our friends at the Furniture Construction, and to all of your team of subcontractors, thank you for all your help and support. And also the city engineer, Doug Ganesh and his staff, all the cityscape work that's been completed, and the new street work that's been completed, they did a fantastic job, and they gave us their support. And we really, really appreciate everything that they've done for us. We also want to say to all of our neighbors, we're sorry for all the dust and inconvenience we've caused you for the past year. But we hope that when the theater opens now, that you will help bear the fruits of all our collective labor, and that we will now reactivate the downtown Monrovia with the theater. We also want to thank Police Chief Santano and Fire Chief Peter Ryan and their entire staffs and department for all the dust that we've set upon their buildings for the last year. And to all the merchants in the downtown area for all their help and support in getting the project approved, and all their help and support in helping us get the project built. Special thanks to Jerry Vanderite, our supply from MTS, who always does a great job getting our seats, projection equipment, sound equipment in. Thank you, Jerry, and to your team. I'd like you to meet some of our Korean Theater staff, beginning with Neil Meyer, our Director of Operations. And I'd like to introduce our new theater manager here in Monrovia, Ted Goldbeck. Ted moved out here. He's now a resident of Monrovia. He moved about two blocks from the theater, so we took away his car. He doesn't need it anymore. And his car allowance. And I'd like to introduce you to Dale Davison, our Director of New Projects. Dale. And Director of Construction Development, Troy McDermott, who always does a great job. Now I'd like to introduce someone very special this evening, the artists that we commissioned to do all of this fantastic digital art that you see on the walls, a young artist who I think in years to come is going to be doing some terrific things that we'll be hearing about him, Greg Valeria. Greg, can you please come up here and let everyone... I'd also like to give thanks to our office staff, particularly for my daughter Jennifer. Jennifer, where are you? Anyway, that's about it. I just want to say again, thank you. I wanted to have this opportunity to provide you with filmed entertainment for the community of Monrovia for the future. Thank you.